Hi guys, today I will be showing you how you can bake normal AO and ID map in Marmoset, and it's really pretty easy. And I'm going to show you some cool options, and then it can help you to get your result properly. So first, how I'm going to start, I'm going to my low poly mesh, which is this one. Okay, so I separated my low poly in four parts, so that I am going to bake in four divisions, like this one in one bake, this one in one bake, this one in one bake, this one. And in the cool things about Marmoset, you don't need to bake one by one these. You can bake whole these at once, and it will be still can be baked without intersecting the normal map from this one to this one. And if you know how to bake normal, then you should know that if I'm going to bake like this, then my normal impression going to be this one and this one, so my normal going to be messed up. So I'm going to show you the cool trick, so you can bake in one time, and you can bake these four parts in single time. Okay so how I splitted this, I choose those objects which are not going to be affect the other parts, so that like if I have choose these two object together, then the normal should be on this one and this one should be this one. So it my normal going to impress with the both the surfaces. So how I split it, that is more important. So choose your parts which not gonna not going to be impressed by any other objects. Okay, like it can't impress this object, it can't impress this object. So choose those objects which are little far from your other model, so that it not get any impressions. Okay, so I divided my low poly in four parts, and I also divided my high poly in four parts. Okay, so these are my four other four objects for my four these low poly. Okay, so as you can see, for this I have this for this, this for this, and this for this. Okay, so I have these four objects in low poly, I have these four objects in high poly. Okay, so now let's talk about the high poly. In the high poly, when you have separate your meshes as per your low poly, like if I have these objects in my low poly, so I should have those objects in my high poly also. Okay, so that it can get baked. Okay, so you need to be doing a poly group, because this process is needed for your ID map. Okay, if you don't need ID map, then you can skip this. Okay, but most cases you need ID map, so this trick gonna help you a lot more. I'm opening my concept. Wait a second. Sorry. Where is? Yeah, here it is. Okay, so as you see, these objects are made with some kind of steel, so these poly groups should be same. Like this one, this object and this object, and under this object, yeah, these three objects are same object. Okay, like same material. So I have keep those things at a single poly group. Okay, like this one. Okay, as you see, this and under this. Okay, this is the single poly group, and this one is different because it has some pattern. And don't worry about this portion because these material are same, but it is on another subtool, so we don't have to worry about that now. Okay, so this screw has steels, so I made these screws in a single poly group. Okay, now you have do you see these picks, something like that? I don't know, I make those in a poly group. I can use this poly group to this also. I think this looks similar, but I can join it if I needed it earlier stages. So but I can't make it split if I don't make it in another poly group. So for now I'm keeping this in a different poly group. Yeah, so as you see, I have this object and I made these in a single poly group and this as a single poly group, so that I can make a ID map for it and have a black color on this in Substance Painter for easily. I don't need to do a mask for this. Okay, so this is how you polygroup your model. Like you see these groups, I made these groups in a single polygroup. These things which have this black material, I have these in a single polygroup. Okay, so this is how you use your polygroups to separate your models. Okay, now next part is now export this. Remember Marmoset, if your PC is average, have average performance, so you then you can get up to 4 million. Okay, and if your PC is more high end, then you can take as much million you can to Marmoset. Doesn't actually import the whole object to his system, it's just referencing the model from your local, so it's no need to worry about. It's not like Maya or Max, it doesn't take it to his interface totally. Okay, it's just create a reference for baking purposes. Okay, so I just export these four okay to let me show you how I export it. Tracer scenes bake. Okay, so I have let me make a old file so that it doesn't. Okay, so I have these four OBJs which I export from ZBrush and exported from Maya. The low one is my low poly, the high one is my ZBrush mesh. Okay, so let's go to Marmoset. Okay, so this is Marmoset. Okay, and I'm just dragging. You can import this or you can drag and drop, it don't actually doesn't matter. It will take a little bit of time to get all the things. Okay, so quickly turn off this. Okay, so as you can see, this is my high poly of this object and this is I name it main shell. Okay, so this is high poly, this is low poly, this is my trigger high poly, low poly, uppercase high poly, low poly, handle high poly, handle low poly. Okay, I have these 8 objects with high poly and low poly options. So how I'm going to let's first make our scene ready for the baking. Okay, so first I'm going to use SDRI, which I used to use. This is one, is this garage one. It is pretty good actually, and I change the mode to color, and the color should be little more grayish. Okay, so that it doesn't disturb you too much. Okay, so this is our high poly and low poly model. Now this is the baker group. It's my version is 3.03. make sure, I actually don't know which marmoset version has with the baker options, but mine has, so I'm going to do it in this version. Okay, so in this baker, when is this group is arrived, what you need to do, this is your main shell, or it is high, right? Then drag and drop in this high box. Okay, and take this main shell low and put it in this one. So what will happen, this group will bake this high poly mesh to this low poly. Okay, and you may thinking that it is easy now, you just create another baker group and put other things, but what will it do, it will make 4 textures for you. I don't want that. I want whole texture should be one. Okay, one texture, 4 objects. Okay, not 4 objects, 4 textures. I don't want that. Okay, so what you need to do, delete this group, and we need a baker group, not a baker. Okay, so click on this baker and click on this option. It will create a baker group, another baker group. Okay, so go to this trigger and add this one, and it is lower one, add to this, and select this one again, add another baker group, select this one, add to here, and select this one, add to here, select this one, add a baker group, and in this way I create 4 baker groups, which is this one, and every baker group contains his high poly and low poly, high poly and low poly, high poly and low poly, high poly and low poly. Okay, so as you see, you can name this also, but I don't think it is necessary, so I will be leaving it. After adding this, you can hide this high poly mesh so that you can look at your low poly. Okay, I will hiding just high poly meshes. Okay, so this is my whole low poly, and my high poly is hidden. So my scene is ready now. So what I need to do, go to this baker, and this is actually your texture size. You can change it here. Okay, and by default it will export the PSD. It's not, don't have any other options, but I used to use TGA. Okay, so you can, what you can do, just name it tracer gun, and it will automatically add normal to normal, height to height, position to position, so you don't need to mention that. You just need to tracer gun dot TGA, so it will export automatically a TGA. Okay, if you need a JPEG, you can also say, write it down as JPEG, but the TGA is much better because it contains more texture informations and color values. Okay, so it's now, and save. So after your name is done and your texture size is done, this is your sampling quality. I will be showing you what is sampling quality in a bit. Okay, now select your baker and bake, and okay, so baking is done, but you can't see it here because it is not assigned here. Okay, so what you need to do, create a material, okay, like this, and assign it to your low poly. Same material to every low poly, okay, not high poly, only low poly. Okay, so I assign it here. Now here is the normal map option on this material tab. Go to this and select the normal map and open. So as you can see, my normal is assigned. It is not here because I am going to flip this one to here and this screws also, so this one not there. Okay, so as I said that they see it is came pretty cool. As you see it in the ZBrush, it is not there actually, it is just floating objects. I didn't make it whole in this surface. It's just another process how we can do this. Okay, so it's now searching for errors, where the errors are. I don't think it's much have error. It's have something here, and okay, so did you seeing this jagginess? It is actually came from your sampling quality. Okay, you can, what you can do, just go to the sample options, go to this 16-bit. But before that I will be like to fix this one. Okay, that will be better. Now how you gonna fix this? First make sure that which objects is this. This is the low poly, this one. Okay, you have to select this low poly icon. You have seen this icon. Okay, it's the baker icon, and you can see the offset now. Okay, now what you need to do, select this low and go to this paint offset. There is a two option, the skew is the different one and the offset is the different one. I will be choosing offset, and to bring out the forward, bring out to forward, you need to press hold control, or if you just do it without pressing it, it will go inside. Okay, so did you see this? Let me do this again. It already baked actually. There is a let me see, I can fix this one. Okay, so did you see this? I'm holding control and just rubbing it little bit, so it will processing. Okay, okay, so it's coming upwards, so I'm releasing my control key and just, yeah, so you have to just click on this surface, it will automatically remove your errors. Okay, yeah, that is fine actually, it's not have any major issue because it is inside on this. Okay, so after you fixing your model, I say that I don't have much errors, but if you have much errors, then first thing you should do, changing your max offset, or you can just estimate offset, it will automatically calculate your offsets and create a cage for you. Okay, so after that you will be having the try this max offset, it until you get the best result. And if you have some errors like this, then you have to select this paint option and just paint it over there. And first just paint by clicking, or if the errors grow bigger, then hold control and press it again, then it will, the mesh will come outside and it will fix your errors. Okay, and the skew option is little different and it is hard to explain, but it will work when you have much edges on a surface, but I don't have any much edges. where I can show. Actually, my model is come up pretty cool, good way, so I can't show you the options. Okay, so do you see this model angling over here towards this and towards to that? So what will happen if you paint skew? It will calculate those high res points and fix your normal by that information. Okay, so it's like locking a vertex on Maya or Max. Okay, it's similar to that, but you can do it in live in this Marmoset software. Okay, so did you see this? I'm cleaning it pretty good way. Okay, so did you see this my just circle just offset from here to there. Okay, so if I paint over here, yeah, imagine that if I have, I think I can show you here. Did you see this? This my circle is little bit oval, looks like a oval. Okay, so how I'm going to do this? I'm just locking this surface like this. Okay, it will come up round like this. Okay, so this is how you can make your so see this, this is little bend, right? So if I'm going to circle it like this for a little bit, so it will automatically get straight. Okay, so I think you got the point. And if you want that, I will make a video on how to bake in Maya, then please comment me in the box. I will show you in that. I'm doing this because this software is pretty much new and do a very good result and almost have no time to bake. So I thought it will be nice if I just make a video on this. Okay, so I'm now going to show you, let me do this also. Okay, so are you seeing this? It's actually lock, how can I explain? Okay, so look at this surface. Okay, it's all these lines are, think like these lines are going from forward and bouncing to your high poly and get back to your mesh and create normal from that projection. Okay, so if your model these angles are in this way, so what will happen, this cylinder is going to project on a side. Okay, so it will distorted much too much like this one. Okay, if you hold control and draw it again, then it will remove those lines what you create. So as you see, these lines are going this way, that's why it's projecting this cylinder in this diagonal angle. Okay, so by doing this, I'm doing this. What will happen, this normal is going to be straighter and it will project exact the straight option. Okay, okay, so I think if you didn't have don't understand what I just did or just say, please do a comment. I will try to make you understand what I did. So this is the paint, bake skew paint. You can see this where I painted. Okay, let me paint over here a little bit. Yeah, so yeah, it's done. Now I can do this also in this surface, it will be much good. Where it is uppercase, this one, yeah. And going to this paint skew and painting this, so it will project exact from the front. And I guess my normal should be get better. Okay. So you can control the size, flow and sharpness also of this brush, but I think the default is working fine, so don't do anything. Okay, so I did this. Okay, so make sure if you're doing this, you should not change your UV, because that texture is going based on your UV. And the best part is, if you draw that once, then you don't need to draw for any of these. Okay, yeah, but if you want to bake any of these first, okay, you have to bake normal first. If your normal is okay, then you can bake everything. Sometimes what happens, if you bake without baking the normal, if you bake AO without baking the normal, your marmoset going to be crash. So first bake your normal, then it will come much easier. Okay, so I think it's came up pretty cool. Okay, so I'm talking about these. Okay, these noise, so this is a sampling. You just need to increase it like this and bake, and don't worry what you paint, it's not gonna go away. It will be still there, because it's UV based, it will project it again for based on your modification, what you modified. Okay, so as you see, it's now it's better, less jaggier. Okay, and this is looks pretty good circles. And go to low paint skew, see these are still here. Okay, so yeah, so I think the normal is came out pretty good. Okay, so now is about how to bake ID. For the ID, you need to let me show you something first. Did you see this material ID? The ID is worked like what you have colored the hyperly is going to be on this surface, but you don't actually need to be like coloring the objects. Okay, you just first you need to create a group. Okay, it is a material group. In this, by selecting this one, you have to create a material. Okay, and now hide your low poly and turn on your high polys. Okay, if your objects are not coming up like this in your high poly, it means you didn't polygroup it properly. Okay, the polygroups are came up here in this sequence. Okay, so let me see. Okay, I will be hiding the low polys for a sec. I don't need now the low polys. Yeah, I will turn down the high poly. Thank you. Okay, so in this file I'm going to assign materials to this surface. Okay, so I will be adding like this. Don't need the colors, but if you have colors then you can see it properly that where you have added the ID. Don't worry, it's not your material color. I'm not going to bake the diffuse, I'm going to bake the ID. It's just for showing that how the which objects are I assigned the materials. Okay, here, so as you see this object is same as this and this also, so I'm going to just drag and drop every same color. Okay, and this one also, this one is much darker, so I'm going to create a new one. I just duplicated it, assigned to this, change the color. Okay, now I think this and this is the same material. Yeah, it looks same, so I just added it over there. Okay, so I added some colors. It's not going to bake this color to those low polys. It actually for checking me that every object has some ID colors. You have to assign only a material to your high poly. It will automatically bake your high poly. Okay. Okay, so now what I need to do, select the baker and you have to make sure you save it because this scene file is really necessary. Oh, it's 40 minutes, it's too much lengthier. Okay, so I'm going to add it in, turn off the normals now. You baked it once, so we don't need it more. Now turn on the material ID, okay, and just bake it. Okay, so material ID is baked. You need to assign it so that you could see it. You can just click this option, it will automatically assign your model, but if you want to see the shaded also, then go to this Albedo and select your material which is baked from this path and select it. What happened? Okay, it is not this material, this is the default material. You have to select the material. Okay, so as you can see it's baked pretty good, and if you have done some correction to this, it automatically update on the ID also, so it is the best thing. Yeah, now let's bake the AO, and make sure you save the file before baking AO, because AO is a pretty heavy thing, ambient occlusion, and bake. So the AO is baked now. To check out, you can also do the same, like assigning this, click this mesh, it will showing on the mesh. So I think the bake case came out pretty cool and clean, and yeah. So I think this video going to be help you. So as you see, in a pretty certain time I got the AO and the ID map and the normal pretty quick. So hope you like it, and please hit that subscribe button to help me, and let's learn together. And yeah, see you next time.